same.
Don't you know your life will turn around?
Resurrection power is here.
Praise God forever, and thank God for the word of faith in season to build you, to strengthen you, to help you get to your destiny. God has made you promises, and we are teaching you how to handle this tortuous terrain, this labyrinthian, undulating process, up and down, twists and turns. That's all that means. Hallelujah. Are you ready for the word? I'm so excited. Come on, let's go. We'll read once again, verse 16. It says, therefore, it is of faith that it might be by grace. So faith is a lifesaver. To the end, the promise might be sure to all the seed, not to that only which is of the law, but to that also which is of the faith of Abraham, who is the father of us all. Let me run to the New Living Translation. So the promise is received by faith. It is given as a free gift, and we are all certain to receive it. Whether or not we live according to the law of Moses, if we have faith like Abraham. See? If we have the faith Abraham had, for Abraham is the father of all who believe. That is what the scripture means when God told him, I have made you the father of many nations. This happened because Abraham believed in the God who brings the dead back to life and who creates new things out of nothing. I know it's a transliteration, but he makes it rather plain. The reason Abraham received it was because he just believed God. Now here is the promise talk. I have made you a father of many nations. That's the promise talk. This was spoken when the man did not have a child. Then why is it difficult for you to believe that you're healed? Why is it difficult to believe that you're prosperous? Why is it difficult for you to believe that God has delivered you from the demons tormenting you? Because you're going by sight and feelings and emotions. This man, his body ended up withering. Sarah was 90 years old. Come on, that's impossible. I wouldn't even want to be bothered with having children at that time. But God said, that's when I want to do it. The question I need to answer, and you need to answer, does God have a right in your life to do it when he wants to? That's the struggle we have. That's why you're getting discouraged. You don't know that your discouragement is actually a mask for your anger. You are disappointed and disenchanted with the process. That's why. It's occluded. It's funny the way it works. You see? Depression. Yes, that's anger. Disappointment. That's really all it is. But faith is the reverse, that you are able to stay in fellowship with God, stay under the anointing, keep worshiping God, keep serving in the ministry, keep laboring in faith, because the promise will come. He has already made you. You are already healed. You are already delivered. I am already healed. I'm already delivered. I'm already blessed. I'm already favored. I'm already the head and not the tail. I'm already that, regardless of my circumstances. That's what bearing the promise to pass. That's what Abraham had to do. That's what he's teaching us to do it. And it doesn't matter how many trillion times I preach this text, I will keep preaching it because I know this is our greatest weakness. Let me read King James. It says once again, therefore it is a faith that it might be by grace. To the end, the promise might be sure to all the seed. You see, nobody has an edge over you. The promise is sure to you and to me and to all of us. Nobody has an edge over you. God has guaranteed this for every one of his children. Not to that only which is of the law, but to that also which is of the faith of Abraham. Yes, Moses has children. But Abraham has children. You better become Abraham's children, because Moses is done. God has moved on. Who is the father of us all? So whether you are in Moses or you are in faith, you are the children of Abraham. They are children of Abraham naturally. We are children of Abraham spiritually. And then when people that in Judaism or serving Moses will come out of that into the Lord Jesus, they become spiritual sons of Abraham. He is the father of us all. As it is written, I have made thee a father of many nations. I have made thee, not I am going to make you. You have to learn the language of the promise. I have made you. I have healed you. I have blessed you. I have succored you. I have increased you. I have favored you. I know somebody said, God showed them I had three jets, but I don't even have a prop, not even one. I finished school in 1988. See? In 2018, even though I know I can't count, but isn't that 30 years? Hallelujah. Yeah? 88, 98, 2008, 2018, 30 years. I haven't seen a prop yet. And every time I try to get a prop just to get going, he said, I don't need your help. I said, well, get it going. No response. But you see, one day, at the right time, there'll not only be one, it'll be one, two, three jets. This one is going here, this one is going there. We end time global harvest will be hitting Satan every day on all cylinders and bringing countless hundreds of thousands into the kingdom and raising orphans and training them as men fathered by us, teaching them character, excellence, strength, vision. I'm so excited, beloved. The future couldn't be brighter, it couldn't be greater, it couldn't be more delicious. I'm finally coming into it. That's why I'm so encouraged. And you're coming with me. You are coming with me. Glory to God. Well, gotta go. They say my time is gone. We love you. We'll see you next week. Pastor Chica. Bye-bye.